Hi all, this is Uttam Singh from Solar Pivot Power with a DIY step-by-step guide for replacing the controller board on a Pecron E3600 LFP power station. We are proud to partner with Pecron and offer a seamless end-to-end solution for camping and home backup power with our portable solar robots. In this setup, you can see that PV input from 200-watt SolBot 1 is charging E1000 at around 180 watts. The same input when connected to E3600 low voltage input provides no power. As you may know, E3600 has three PV input ports, a low voltage port supporting a voltage range of 12 to 30 volts, and two high voltage ports supporting a voltage range of 32 to 150 volts. It's likely that in the past I fat fingered and connected a high voltage PV input incorrectly to the low voltage port. Pecron was kind enough to send me a replacement controller board. These are the tools I ended up using, in particular a long and short Phillips head along with hex keys. A plastic wedge came in handy when removing a few connectors, and tweezers when I dropped screws in tight spaces. I started with the bottom of the unit. There are four short screws, and then slide the corner bumpers out to access the four long bolts. Next, working on the top of the unit, there are actually no fasteners under the corner bumpers. There are four long bolts that attach the handles to the body. I removed those to access the two hex bolts marked in blue. Next, gently pull up the top cover and disconnect the wireless charger connector. After this, the top cover can be removed. Please make a note of the order of the connectors attached to the top subassembly. We will need to remove the top subassembly to make room and reach the controller board fasteners. The top subassembly is fastened with six Phillips head screws. Next, remove the connectors and slide the top assembly out. Now you should have enough room to reach the 9+2 screws used to attach the controller board to the main body. This corner screw is particularly difficult to access. Also, to disconnect the ribbon connector, you will need to first slide the black tab out, and then the ribbon will slide out easily. Next, for reassembly, just reverse the previous steps. I did a quick test of the low voltage port before closing the top cover. The entire process should take 30 to 60 minutes. Finally, you can get an additional 5% savings on Pecron products by using our discount code. Links are in the description. Thank you for joining. If you like this content, please like and subscribe to our channel. Till next time.